There's the situation in the women's Omnium after two of six races. Sarah Hammer ahead of Tara Whitten. Laura Trott, Edmondson, Kahura make up the top five. We've got the elimination race to come, the third race on the first day of the multi-event Omnium. It includes the 500 time trial tomorrow. Sarah Hammer, vastly experienced, very, very versatile rider. Because the riders in the elimination have a GPS tracking device in the base of the handlebars to indicate to the rider if they are the last across the line. And they'll sprint, and basically the last is eliminated. So you've got to position yourself well, got to be very mentally alert in this style of racing.
Another entertaining bunch race in the Women's Omnium.
Earlier this year, it was Trott ahead of Romuto and Voitra, with Whitten and Edmondson making up the top five. And Voitra, we know, stole a lap, worked very hard on the point score. It'll be interesting to see how that affects her in this elimination.
Could be a factor. She won the elimination in the World Cup event in Beijing in January this year, at which time many of these riders, to be fair, were in different phases of preparation for the Olympic Games, or particularly for the World Championships and then the Olympic Games. So you can read an enormous amount into that. Sarah Hammer, she was seventh in the elimination of the World Championships. Tara Whitten, the 32-year-old Canadian, is here, who went really well in the points race. Running after as they go down the track. Push and let them go. And tomorrow, the chief commissaire here, they're worried about pushing off the rail at the top. They just push off. There we go. Tara Whitten, away they go in the elimination. Last across the line. It's eliminated, so it's exciting and can get very tense indeed. Rider scramble to avoid being that last rider. The gun. Elimination race in the Women's Omnium, the third event in the Omnium. Second lap, there's the bell. We've got 17 sprints, so the last rider across the line gets eliminated. Paul, who won the points race, Voitra, she's in pole position now. And out goes Gonzalez, the Venezuelan. Flashing light on her sensor on the handlebars telling her she must drop out. Tara Whitten staying up front whilst really Alvazada Voitra is keeping herself in danger. Yeah, really in danger. And I think she is going to go out there.
Very close between her and the Colombian rider, Kelly Williams.
Oh, I think
the women's actually. That's very, very tight, or even the rider from Chinese Taipei, Xiao. So that's one that the commissaires will have to look.
Yeah, because she's still in there. In fact, she's rolling back the rider from Chinese Taipei.
So they're sprinting now for elimination, and there's a flick of the wheel. And it might be this time the rider from China. It is. She thinks she's still integrated, but now that the light goes off, the flashing light. Remember, these riders had the sprint over the flying 250, done so much work in the point score. And Sharankova, the battle Russian, in last place at the moment. She tried to thread her way through the field and look for a position, but it will be Sharankova. An early elimination, because it does put pressure on the points tally. Voigt was ridden with a lot of confidence back in the field, but now she's dicing with trouble. She moves up on the outside of Lee, the Korean. Gild is there too from Holland. Voigt tries to sprint quickly. Oh, maybe the rider on the inside that's missed out. It is rider number 14, it appears, Kelly Williams this time.
Flashing there, so she must withdraw herself from the race.
I'm not sure how she can't see the light.
Yeah, right in front of her. Ultra continues to flirt with danger here, and Kelly Williams is still riding. And Laura Trotz keeping herself out of trouble. Here's the sprint. Ooh. Very, very tight now. Who's it going to be? The Korean or the Polish rider is still in there. Sarah Hammer is on the front and...
Very close. There is
very
a,
close.
A flashing light. It may be that the French rider who's out. Clara Sanchez, a sprint. Voigt is at the back. She tries to come quickly on the outside, and yes, she has done it once more. She survived.
She's flirting with danger the whole time. It's Oliveira, the Spaniard, will go out. Well, there's two ways to do it, I suppose. Tara Whitney can see all the main contenders up at the front there, keeping themselves out of trouble, or you can hang at the back and just for the sprint in the last 30 metres to avoid being relegated or eliminated.
One too many for Voigt, but perhaps
she, I think so,
she's missed out.
No, she survives.
That must have been so close. It was just a more than a tire whip, didn't it? Still hanging at the back with the Russian rider, and Laura Trotz there too in a bit of trouble. Voigt this time caught on the inside, so it's not the place to be. They'll rush pretty quickly on the outside, and it is Voigt this time that's out.
Yeah, she has survived. But you see Tara Whitten up front there. Edmondson's been up front as well for pretty much the whole way. Well, it's Joanne Zanowski, the New Zealander, and Sarah Hammer as well, keeping themselves up front, but what they put in now could come back to bite them in the second day of the Omnium. Now Laura Trotz under a bit of pressure. Romanuta is there as well. Trotz and Romanuta. Laura Trotz in trouble here. She just gets away, and it's a Cuban rider who will go out. We have 9 riders left. Edmondson really got in trouble there. It gets really tense as the riders field things down. Kirsten Veit has a look over her shoulder and realizes she's down the tail end here and trots right up front and safe. Whitten is going to be eliminated now, the Canadian. Looks down at her center. It should be her, I think.
It is now since the light has gone off. Edmondson caught at the back with Romanuto, the Russian. Sarah Hammer there too. Riders are tiring after a tough point score. Romanuto off the back at the moment. She'll try to sprint late around Hammer. And they come late. Is it the New Zealander missing out? It is. Kuzanowski.
Well, it's a classic case. She was not being challenged by anyone, but the battle between Romanuto and Edmondson saw Kuzanowski getting left behind.
Down to six riders. Romanuto just hanging off the back. Trying to tack onto the wheel of Kirsten Veit, who's looked a little bit exposed in the last couple. Romanuto, though on tired legs at the moment. She comes on the outside. Kirsten Veit's there. Oh, that's pretty close. It may be Kirsten Veit who's missed out, but only a tyre width in it.
Tyre Whitten, I think it's the one is. She was the last one, bigger part, and it is the Belgian to miss out. You heard her. Edmondson, Wilt, there's Romanuta, Trot, and Hammer. It winds up now, the crowd urging Trot to stay out where she is now. She's going to come under pressure from Sarah Hammer. Trot's going to have to work hard here. And it may be Kirsten Veit who'll go out. Oh, the duck rider, Kirsten Veit, misses out and is eliminated.
Four riders. Who's got the sharper sprint? Positioning is pretty important too. And this comes a match race situation. They flip the wheel and now it's Romanuto last place at the moment. Edmondson leads from Hammer. Laura Trott, Romanuto, they all flip the wheel. Oh, it's Romanuto who's going to miss out, but whether the commissaires will have a look. There's a lot of aggressive riding in that last 100 metres. Romanuto extremely fatigued is the one that goes out. Sarah Hammer just came across Laura Trott, almost a domino effect.
Yep. Three up now, Edmondson, Hammer and Laura Trott, the world champion. So they're all winding it up now for the sprint. Edmondson is leading them out. Hammer and Trott, who's it going to be here? Trott is showing the experience, she'll get through easy. And it is Edmondson at the toll of the laps and the pace that the riders up front have maintained. Eventually sees to it that she goes out. Now two up, Hammer and Trott. Remember, the winner of this event gets 1 point and really is valuable. Laura Trott's already won the flying lap.
It could be a very good point to earn for Trott. Just a point separates these two. And it's Sarah Hammer who leads. Laura Trott's got her on the outside. And there she goes, the world record holder in the team's pursuit. And the favourite here goes to the lead. 1 point from Laura Trott. 2 points to Sarah Hammer. Has them tied on 12. And it's a fascinating contest after three events in the Women's Omnium.
Waving as she went over the line there, Sarah Hammer. Did her part in an entertaining elimination race, but Laura Trott of Great Britain got into a spot of bother once or twice, but managed to negotiate her way out of it and takes a win in the elimination race, the Women's Omnium. Explosive stuff.
always a crowd favourite. The elimination gets everybody involved. If you're sitting next to someone, the debate happens. Who finished last? It's always tight for that decision, especially early on in the elimination. The race basically integrated into track cycling to do just that, entertain the crowd. That's an important part of the Omnium. And Laura Trott continues the British joy on day five on the velodrome with one to go.
She'd sit up, afford to have a smile and a wave because Sarah Hammer had not dropped the hammer and she'd just backed off. There's not much she could do with a British girl in such fine form.
It's not inconceivable that Britain can win the remaining three gold medals up for grabs. They've got five of seven. And they've got Laura Chop now leading the Omnium. Pendleton, a favourite to win gold in the women's sprint. And, of course, the big men and the Kieran go off with Chris Hoy, the reigning Olympic champion.
And the 1 point to the winner, and then all the way down the field. One more point for each, so 2, 3, 4, 5. Down to last place in the elimination race, because Andrew Gonzalez is the first to be eliminated. The race for places 5th, 5, 6, 7 and 8 in the women's sprint. And four riders involved here. Felica, Panarino, Rodriguez and Kukushaita. That's how it is after three of the six races, the women's Omnium. Laura Trott and Sarah Hammerlock to 12 points. Edmondson on 17. Tara Whitten, the Canadian, is there as well on 18 points. Three more events to come. It's going to be fascinating racing.